गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम इन क्लास बीए पार्ट थर्ड। टुडे वी हैव टू स्टार्ट ए वेरी शॉर्ट पॉइंट ऑफ आवर सिलेबस, दैट इज पोस्ट कार्ड फ्रॉम कश्मीर, आगा शाहिद अली। एज द टाइटल ऑफ पॉइंट वी अंडरस्टैंड वेरियस थिंग्स ऑटोमेटिकली। एज द फीचर ऑफ टाइटल it must be comprehensive as well as it should hint something. As the feature of title, we are not discussing about the title of English literature's point. Anytime, whenever we are discussing title, they must show something, they must indicate something, they must be in a live position so that readers can think something about the आइडियाज गिवन दैट है। तो पोस्ट कार्ड फ्रॉम कश्मीर इज ए कॉमन टाइटल एंड अकॉर्डिंग टू इट्स लाइक टाइटल वी कैन अंडरस्टैंड दैट देयर मे बी ए पोस्ट कार्ड विच जस्ट डिलीवर्ड फ्रॉम कश्मीर। द टाइटल ऑफ पॉइंट एज वेल एज द नेम ऑफ पॉइंट सीम्स अस इंडियन, बट वी कंसिडर्ड इन स्टार्टिंग that first, second, third poem of your syllabus written by Indian poets. Means in first unit only three poets are Indian poets, others belonging to different type of countries of the world. Someone are from Canada, someone is from Australia, Singapore, America and various others. Today must not be confusion in mind that Agha Shahid Ali seems to be Indian, but he considers himself as an American poet. He considers himself as an American poet. It is right that he was born in Delhi, the capital of India. But later, his education and childhood was spent in Kashmir, and after finishing education, he went settled in America and started to work in America, started to settle job in America, and till last of his death, he lived there and expired there. Means, basically, Agha Shahid Ali belongs to India. He born in Delhi. Later, his family diverted in Kashmir, a part of India. We can consider it heaven on earth. Heaven on earth. Kashmir is the soul of this poem. Kashmir is the keynote of this poem. You can understand about Kashmir. And the complete poem written upon Kashmir, or it is the key word or key note of this point. Everything that is the detail of this point, everything that was given in this point, every narration, incident and happening, every narration, incident and happening of this point are directly or indirectly belongs to the word Kashmir. Means Kashmir is the soul of this poem. Now how Kashmir comes here, how it is the part of Agha Shahid Ali at the time when he shifted in America, that is the matter of understanding. We just start the basic introduction of poem, and before we just start to introduce this poem, I request you must have a textbook, because we just start after some time the text of this poem, a very short play. So you must have a textbook. In that textbook, there is also the details related about the poet. About the poet is must to understand everyone. We are not reading here every line word by word, but the basic conception related to poet clear in mind. Now we can understand that. The introduction of poet, there is three things that is important related to Agha Shahid Ali. there is three things that is important related to Agastya Nagar. First, that is Delhi. Keep in mind. Second, that is Kashmir. And third, that is United States of America. There is a reason to write down these three names separately according to the chart. And the introduction of poet, you must understand what is the reason to write these three here. The reason is very clear. It should be completely settled in mind and well connected with it. Agastya Nagar is considered as a multi-talented poet. Multi-talented poet. How we can say that? Agastya Nagar was a multi-talented poet, right? We now just prove how he considered as multi-talented means. Understand? Delhi Nagar, that means birth. Kashmir, that means childhood. And early education. USA, well settled, complete life spent in USA. Now, you try to understand how Agastya Nagar is considered as a multi-talented, multi-dimensional poet. There is the effect. As he born in Delhi, means here he just tried to understand, he just know about Hindu culture and system. He born in Delhi, here he just acquired the knowledge related to various types of traditions, related to various types of systems, various types of customs, related to Hindu culture, Hindu tradition, Hindu customs, Hindu usages, Hindu culture, or everything that was considered as the prime pillar of Hindu religion, because he belongs to them. Means in his poetry, there may be the touch of Hindu culture and system. Or all these are the attachment of any poet to which period, to which era, to which religion, to which culture, to which civilization he belongs. All these keeps their importance. All these have their great effect on the poetry of it. We are not discussing about poetry of Agastya Nagar. Any poet, whatever the name, the effect of religion, effect of culture, effect of civilization, effect of culture, usage, customs, all these are the effective part of a poetic achievement of any poet. So I am telling you that in the poetry of Agastya Nagar, we just try to know because he is just a poet to attach with Hindu culture also in Delhi. Later he directed in Kashmir, that is Muslim culture. So according to the system and civilization of Kashmir, he just get the knowledge, he just acquired the system related to Muslim culture, related to Muslim tradition, Muslim usages, Muslim civilization. Here we must found the touch of Muslim culture, same as Hindu culture, understand by him in Delhi, Muslim culture understood by him in Kashmir, and later
he diverted in USA. What he learned there? He learned their various culture that was in fashion there. That is Western. That is Western culture. Means Hindu culture, Muslim culture, and Western culture. All are effective there in the poetry of Agha Shahi Pandit. These are the basic features. Agha Shahi Pandit, well connected, well considered with three different types of culture, because he just passed their time, passed his time in these three types of culture. It was an important aspect related to Agha Shahi Pandit. We must have knowledge about it, or we must get information that how Agha Shahi Pandit is considered as multi-talented poet. Because Hindu culture, Muslim culture, and Western culture, all these three are well affected. All these three well formed in Agha Shahi Pandit's poetry. Now we consider the title Postcard from Kashmir. As you know that postcard is the piece of paper having light yellow color. Postcard is the piece of paper having light yellow color. Its size is 4 into 6 inch. 4 into 6 inch. That is considered as postcard. Post means the process to import and export the pieces of paper. Card, you understand, card, that is card. So postcard. The name of postcard may surprise the young generation. The name of postcard may be a wonder for young generation today, because today young generation is so systematic and technological that it believes on live telecast communication and transmission. Today is the era of IT, information technology, and the era of science, advancement of science and technology. And at the present time, if we are discussing about the metro postcard, it is, I think, for the youth of present time, maybe some type of confusion in their mind, but it was the starting medium of communication. Postcard was the starting medium of communication. We put our address of destination and drop into the box of post office, and after 3, 4, 5, 7, 8 days, according to the distance of destination, these type of the part of paper card delivered there, they spent, they read it and give its reply again. This was a very interesting way of communication that was very popular in India. And at the time when Agha Shahi Pandit was in America, Agha Shahi Pandit was in America in a very aged period, and just spent the life in America, well settled in America. He just found a postcard, and that postcard is from Kashmir. Now, as you know that Agha Shahi Pandit spent his childhood and early childhood and then later education in Kashmir. So every moment which he spent in Kashmir was in the mind of Agha Shahi Pandit. It is not the matter he every time remembers his home. He never remembers it. But any hint when comes automatically, their sudden jump of emotions and feeling. So this is the postcard that was coming here. And automatically, as the postcard received by the poet, he just remembers, start to remind the days which he spent in Kashmir. He reminds his home in Kashmir. He reminds the natural valleys of Kashmir, the natural picture of Kashmir, the Jhelum River of Kashmir, the Himalaya mountain in Kashmir, or every type of the thing that was very useful there. In that postcard was now the source of inspiration, postcard is now the source of memory, and it is the source of his childhood that comes again today. So the postcard as received by the poet, everything coming in the mind. Now we just started text and you are requested to observe the book, that is Poetic Reflection India and Abroad. I am repeating the title again and again, and you know the reason very well. I am not repeating the reason now. Postcard from Kashmir is a deep sentiment, is a collection of emotions, is a beautiful regetting and recollected ideas related to childhood. Now poet becomes very emotional. He becomes very sensitive because everything is moving in the mind of poet. His home, his location, his locality, natural beauty, his neighborhood, his childhood friends, his parents, his friends, everyone there are in the mind of poet. Now suddenly comes, postcard is not coming here as a piece of paper, it is coming here as a vehicle of emotion, as a transport of feeling and sentiments. See it now, Kashmir sinks into my mailbox, sinks Shikurna, Samajan, into my mailbox, mail, American word, same as we are calling in post in India, that is British word. Same as we are calling post, that is American, British word, using in India, and same as we are calling mail, meaning is same, it is American word. So mailbox is now, you can understand, as an American English, the mail is used for the post box. Mailbox, you can understand it about post box. Poet is now speaking that same as, just as I received a postcard from Kashmir, what he is observing, my home. Poet observed his home. Home is used for both the special location of his home as well as complete senses related with the land of Kashmir. Home is used for the motherland of Kashmir. Poet says that, whenever I just received the postcard on my palm, I just get the home that was on my palm. Kashmir was in my hand now. My home is in my hand now. Everything there is in my home now. A neat is used for very clean. Neat, very soft, clean, sweet, saaf sutra mera ghar, 4x6 inches. इस चार पूछे के कागज के टुकड़े पे साफ सुथरा मेरा घर समाया हुआ है. दिस इज द लाइन एक्सप्लेनेशन ऑफ टू. दिस इज टू लाइन्स एक्सप्लेनेशन व्हेन पोएट सेज दैट माय वेरी ब्यूटीफुल क्लीन होम सिचुएटेड ऑन दिस पीस ऑफ पेपर. दिस इज नॉट ओनली ए पीस ऑफ पेपर फॉर मी, इट इज ए सोर्स ऑफ माय मेमोरी. It is a medium of my reminding related Kashmir. Then I always love neatness. Or neatness, saaf sutra, swachhata, cleanness, beauty, naturality. I always love. Mujhe hamesha hi badhiya lagti thi. Means poet says that I was the lover of nature. I am the lover of nature. I will be the lover of nature. Yes. Now I hold. Ab maine rakh rakha hai haath mein postcard hai. The half inch Himalaya in my hand. Now the picture of Himalaya there may be on the postcard and its size is only half inch. Then poet says that now Himalaya is in my hand in half inch. The proper Himalaya there was not possible to write down on postcard. Poet says that now the Himalaya is in my hand in half inch. Now the Himalaya is in my hand in half inch. He is observing the postcard. This is home. Ye mera ghar. Very beautifully, poet says very emotionally that this is Kashmir and it is my home. And this the closet I will ever be a home. Aur ye mere itne close rehta hai ki ye hamesha mera ghar yahi rahega. Poet considers Kashmir as his home forever. Although he is living in America today, but according to him, Kashmir was his home. It is his home, or it will be his home forever. हमेशा हमेशा उसका घर यही रहेगा. When I return, और अगर मैं लौट करके जाऊं, पीछे लौट के जाना, मतलब he just reminding the days when he left Kashmir. He just reminding the memories when he was there in Kashmir. I said the colors wouldn't be so brilliant. तो पता नहीं अब इसके कलर इतना ब्रिलियंट होगा क्या. कलर मीन्स रंग, सिस्टम, सिविलाइजेशन, पॉलिटिकल सिस्टम, सोशल सिस्टम, एनवायरमेंटल सिस्टम, एवरीथिंग. अब उसका कलर मतलब रंग. कलर स्पेलिंग शुड बी नोटेड, COLOR, COLOR, COLOUR, अमेरिकन वर्ड दैट इज और दैट इज British word. Sometimes we are considering that in English, various types of the word seems us wrong. Various types of the word seems us wrong. But at the time when we are discussing about the meaning of British and American word, at the time when we search out the meaning of British and American word, then we consider that. Same as color, that is an American word. Color, that is an, you can say that is British word. Some words are differ in American and British English. We have the time and the connection, so you just know that. Same as we are like, just we are writing program, then program, both spellings are right. But this is the spelling belongs to America. This is an American word. And program is the British word. Never be confused. In India, British words are applicable. In India, British words are applicable. When you are working on computer screen, and then you put the spelling program, you will found red line under it, because red line refers for wrong word, because the system of computer deals with American English. Same as we just write center, C-E-N-T-R-E is the right word, C-E-N-T-E-R, American word. So must we keep a difference? Sometimes some are confused about the spellings. So never be confused. Some meanings are different. Others or maximum meanings are the same. Either that is British English or that is American English. But only some few words are different. You try to search out all these words. We should take or we can make a different type of video in another time. And I shall try to provide you a video in which we maximum try to analysis the difference between the particular words and American and British words. So we will try to make a video related to these types of the words. They create confusion in mind. And next we just come on our point. So the colors are now so changed now. The झेलम water so clean, so alkaline. झेलम का जो पानी है, झेलम is the name of river in Kashmir. कश्मीर में नदी का नाम है झेलम. उसका जो पानी है so clean, वो तो आज भी वैसा ही साफ है. Means nature is unaffected by social and political system. Nature is unaffected by social and political system. Everything was there, may be changed. Social, political, systematic, everything seen, that is changed. But Himalaya, Jhelum, nature's beauty, natural beauty, all are same now. Abhi bhi vaisi hi hai, same hai. When I, the Jhelum's water so clean, so alkaline, alkaline, so alkaline, sea crossed. समुद्र को पार करना, यानी ये जो पानी जो समुद्र में झेलम नदी का गिर रहा है आज भी उतना ही पवित्र है। माई लव सो ओवर एक्सपोज्ड, ओवर एक्सपोज्ड, ओवर एक्सप्रेसिव, आई हैव रोट द वर्ड टू एक्सप्रेस माई लव फॉर कश्मीर, आई हैव रोट द वर्ड टू एक्सप्रेस माई लव फॉर कश्मीर, आई हैव रोट द एक्सप्रेशन हाउ आई कैन एडमायर माई लैंड, हाउ आई कैन एडमायर द ब्यूटी ऑफ माई कश्मीर, एंड माई मेमोरीज लाइक मेमोरीज विल बी अ लिटिल आउट ऑफ फोकस। अब तो ये पोस्ट कार्ड आ गया, अदरवाइज ही इज नॉट रिमाइंडिंग कश्मीर, दिस इज ओरिजिनैलिटी। सो ही सेज दैट पोस्ट कार्ड वॉज नॉट ओनली अ पोस्ट कार्ड, इट इज ए सोर्स ऑफ माई मेमोरी, इन इट गेट नेगेटिव ब्लैक एंड व्हाइट स्टिल अंडरडेवलप्ड, स्टिल अंडरडेवलप्ड इज अंडरडेवलपमेंट। Then Poet says that this is the picture of Kashmir, and Kashmir always remained the topic of discussion in India, and when I left Kashmir the picture was something another, I don't know what is the picture they are today. Everything that was presented by Poet is very beautiful, and briefly we can say that postcard from Kashmir is a beautiful piece of representation. It is a collection of emotions or memories. In our next video, we will start another topic. Thank you.